watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
For the community, by the community.
Get ready to find hope. Get ready to be inspired. Get ready to discover your full potential. Get ready for total success. From the Total Success Coach, Princess Bola Adelani.
Hi, this is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, welcoming you to Inspired Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power, the program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. Thank you so much for tuning in. It's spring. Voila. Yes, it is spring. Officially, spring is here. It's the month of April. And I'm really very excited because after spring is summer. And, you know, we are ready to get out there and ready to spring alive. And that is what this show, this broadcast is all about today. We're going to be talking about the tips, tools, and strategies for us to spring alive, get back our energy after almost 3 months of being snowed in, iced in, locked in, caged in, whatever you want to call it, shut in. You know, and we know how the winter months are, you know, you're kind of low energy, doing very little outdoors, very little moving around. And then as spring comes, you know, you're just kind of dragging your feet if you're like me. And but this broadcast today, I have in the studio with me to be sharing with you, my viewers, the tips, tools and strategies for rejuvenating, getting back your energy, and really springing back to life. And I am just so excited because I always say this, I'm probably like you, like exercising, you know, fitness is like the F word. You know what I'm saying? I just don't even like to do it. I don't like to talk about it. You know, I can find it very intimidating. It just sounds like work. You know, but 3 years ago, I met this phenomenal guest of mine. Her name is Lisa Soloway. She's the owner of Fitness Emotion LLC. And, you know, I met her at an event where she was doing some demonstrations and things like that. And I've never, I tell you this, and I mean this, I've never met anybody who makes, you know, fitness and, you know, exercising as fun as Lisa makes it, honestly. And so it is my great honor and my great pleasure to welcome to Inspired Success today, Miss Lisa Soloway.
Thank you for having me, Bola. I'm excited to be here too.
Well, tell us a little bit about this unique thing that you have going, Fitness in Motion. I mean, that is just so unique and so different because you actually take your fitness practice on the road.
It was born out of the understanding that some people don't feel comfortable working out in a gym.
Yes.
Some people really aren't sure what to do, how to get started. And so I wanted to really reach out to those kind of people.
Okay.
And I remember before I got into fitness, I had no idea what to do. What did my body need? What should I start first? So I actually got into fitness as a my own desire to figure out what I should do. And because I knew somehow up here that I should exercise because I knew I wanted to be healthy and strong. So I became a fitness instructor and just really loved it, connected, because I was with people, helping people in a fitness environment, in a
yes.
gym. And so, but there were many people that I was encountering that didn't feel comfortable going
yes.
to a gym.
Exactly.
So that is why, you know, once I became a personal trainer also, I wanted to be able to reach out to those people and just help them with whatever personal goals they had in regards to their fitness.
And I think the beautiful thing about it is that not only is it that people, you know, may not be able to find the time, make the time to go out, but some people like me just find the whole concept of going to the gym very intimidating. Mm-hmm. You see all those machines there and you're like, you know, where do I even start from? And, you know, like I was saying earlier in my opening, it's like the F word, you know, exercising, gym, you know? And so I think it's really very cool that you would actually bring it. You go to people's homes and you go to people's workplaces. Is that correct?
Yes.
Absolutely. So no excuse.
Yeah, you know? wherever it's best for them.
Wherever they are, you know, wherever is best for you. So you are without excuse no longer, because all you need to do is pick up the phone, schedule that time, and she'll come and she'll meet you right there where you are. That is just so great. I think that is just so cool, really, Lisa. And thank you so much that you're doing that and providing that service to people. I think that's really cool. So now let's just kind of jump right in. We don't have too much time. So today my guest is Lisa Soloway, the owner of Fitness in Motion LLC. She's based out of Glastonbury, Connecticut, but she goes on the road. She's on motion, in motion. And so she will come to you, she'll come to your workplace, whatever, whenever it's convenient for you, to bring it to you and meet you where you are, which is just so, so great. And we're talking today about the tips and the tools and the strategies for really springing back alive after so many months of being shut in, you know, with the winter. And so, you know, tell me one of the first things, how do we get physically fit? I mean, that's a $1 million question. I know you make it fun, you make it simple, but how do we begin this process? What are the steps and the tips and the tools and the strategies? We wanna know.
Okay. Well, there are 5 components to fitness, and the first one that I really, really tell everybody to start with is just get moving. You know, it's to take care of your heart, your lungs, and your circulatory system. It's cardiovascular endurance.
Okay.
And it's as simple as going for a walk. And this is a good time because the flowers are coming out.
Yes.
The birds are chirping.
Exactly.
And so it's really great to just get out there. And a lot of times people don't want to go by themselves. So get a friend, get, you know, your loved one, grab someone and have them go. That really helps, because that helps keep you motivated because you're accountable to one another.
Exactly.
So I always recommend, you know, find someone to go with you. You can take a Zumba class. If you like dance, dance is great exercise. So I really recommend that as an option as well. And, you know, Zumba's all over the place.
Yes, it is.
So try that. If you like bike riding, bike ride, kayaking. So I find a key is find something that you can enjoy, even if exercise is the F word.
Exactly.
Find something that you enjoy. I don't feel like people call them workouts. Yeah. I think they should be fun outs.
Yes, I
you know,
know
you got to have fun so you keep them coming back for more.
Exactly. So really, you're saying the first thing in terms of getting going, getting fit, physically fit, is to find out something you enjoy, which is what I always teach. Anyway, that's my philosophy.
Mm-hmm.
First and foremost is to locate your passion. Something that you enjoy doing that will get you moving. Be it dancing. For example, I love to dance.
Mm-hmm.
So for me, dancing will be really kind of something I can resonate with to do as a form of exercise. You know, others love to walk. Mm-hmm. Others like to, you know, do mountain climbing.
Mm-hmm.
Different kind of activities. But there must be something. It might be something like basketball for some people. You know, and whatever it is that you really find to enjoy, that you personally enjoy doing, then kind of build your exercise regimen, quote unquote, around that.
Correct.
So that's the one of the first attempts. And you were saying in terms of that, make that decision after you've located what it is that you'll enjoy, what will work for you.
One of the things that I like to share with people, if they're not exercising yet, is you really want to think about the life you want to live. How do you want to feel in 5 years, in 10 years from now? And getting moving is going to help you feel your best in 5 and 10 years from now. And so decide.
Okay.
If you haven't started yet, decide to exercise today. All right.
Okay.
So that is the first thing I say.
First step towards getting physically fit. After this whole winter season, decide. Make up your mind that I am going to be fit.
And then think about the future.
Right.
Think about the future today. Mm-hmm. You know, think about 5 years from now, how old you want to be. You want to be able to run around with your grandkids or and so on and so forth, and you want to be around. And it's little simple things, right,
oh, yeah.
which we're going to be touching on towards later on in the broadcast. Mm-hmm. And then so you decide, and then what next?
So the second component to physical fitness is muscular strength.
Okay.
And so I equate that to, for example, you're doing a bicep curl, just like this. How much weight? Is it a 5 pound dumbbell, 8 pound dumbbell? That's your strength.
Okay.
So that's an easy way to incorporate and understand what strength means. The third is muscular endurance. Okay. How many times can you lift that 5 pound dumbbell?
Okay.
So that's the third component.
Okay. Now, in terms of, coming up with a plan, coming up a fitness plan, is it important for an individual to identify where or which part of their body they really want to strengthen? Or is the general goal in terms of fitness, the heart, keeping the heart pumping and moving and strong? Is it to, because like I find that, sometimes I run a few, walk a few, even less than a mile, mm-hmm. and I'm out of breath,
mm-hmm.
okay? So what is responsible for that? Is it just enhancing our level of, is it tolerance or endurance?
Endurance,
exactly.
Yeah.
So what is the general, or is this something that each individual has to discover for themselves, or is the general fitness plan or goal to increase that endurance?
That would be the first thing. That's why I say the first is the cardiovascular endurance. You want to be able to do everything you want to do in a day.
Yes.
And like you say, if you want to, play catch or chasing your grandchildren, you want to have the stamina to be able to do that.
Okay.
So you've got to get moving. You got to get your heart rate elevated for, 20 minutes,
yes.
30 minutes. You can even do it in 10-minute segments.
Okay.
So you can do it throughout the day in 10-minute segments because people are busy when people work.
Exactly.
It can be challenging to find that time.
Yes.
So you can break it up into intermittent 10-minute segments as well.
So one of the primary goals is to increase that stamina,
Right. That would be the first thing.
And
then you can add some strength conditioning.
Okay.
And it's a general rule of 8 to 10 exercises. And I'm going to show you some exercises that we can do.
Yes.
I have two that will work your lower body, and then the other one works your upper body.
Okay.
And so it's typically 8 to 10 exercises that you do to target the major muscles in your body.
Okay, great.
Okay? And that translates to things that we do during the day. Think about, spring's coming.
Yeah.
I don't know about you, but I have two big tubs of clothes. They're up on my shelf. And so I have to be able to bring them down so I can then put my clothes in my drawer.
Exactly.
So very simple things that we do in life that we take for granted all the time. So we want that strength, be able to do everything we want to do every day.
Mm. And so you've heard it. Number one thing you need to decide. Number two is you need to identify, identify what it is your primary goal in terms of fitness is concerned. Mm-hmm. The general fitness goal is that you want to increase your stamina, your endurance level. Many of us can identify with me going on or taking a short walk and kind of find yourself out of breath. And so that's kind of one of the first place to start. So you have enough energy to really do the things you want to do.
Mm-hmm.
And so after that, I would talk about a plan in terms of coming up with a simple plan, with measurable steps that works for you. And that's the advantage of and the benefit of having someone like you who would bring fitness to their home, because the people then need to kind of look at their schedule and say, yes, this is where I can fit it in, where that it flows, kind of seems like a natural flow of their lifestyle and to include that. And so what kind of simple exercises can they do, for the working professional behind their desk, for the stay-at-home mom, for anyone that they can really kind of put into their everyday life without going out of their way per se to exercise?
Two exercises I always recommend are squats Okay. And push-ups. Okay. Squats use your thighs and your hips.
Okay.
Push-ups use your upper body, your chest, shoulders, arms, and upper back.
Okay.
So those are two exercises I incorporate in my clients' exercise plan.
Yes.
And there are a variety of ways to do them, which is really exciting because you will never get bored. Okay.
Good.
It's very important to be, you know, things always changing up because your body's muscles will adapt in about 6 to 8 weeks.
Okay, good. So, now you're going to be showing us in a few minutes, but before we get into the demo part of the broadcast, you know, we want to talk about diet because I've heard conflicting things, you know, about what to eat before you exercise, what not to eat, and what to eat after, and whether you should drink water, whether you should use those kind of energy drinks like Propel or Gatorade, you know, heard all kinds of things like that. So, you know, what say you, Lisa? What say you in terms of preparing your body and your mind? We've talked about the mind in terms of you need to decide, locate your passion, find out what it is that you enjoy that gets you moving. For me, I was giving myself as an example. I said it's dancing. So, you know, probably something like Zumba will probably work better for me because the listening to the music and whatever will seem more like, you know, fun than exercising to me. Right. But, you know, so we've talked about that and we've talked about having the plan and trying to include something in your lifestyle that, you know, makes it simple and natural. And then now I want us to talk about that before you do that demo. What say you? What do we eat? Do I have a big meal? Use that opportunity to you know, get to McDonald's and order a triple Mac or whatever milkshake and say, okay, I'm going to be working out soon. So, you know, let me indulge, what say you?
A couple of things I want to say. The first thing is I will address your questions, and then I want to get back to, we have two more components of fitness that I want to make sure everybody knows about.
Okay.
Before you exercise, depending on the time, if you are a morning person, you want to exercise first thing, remember that food is energy.
Okay,
so,
yes.
And you need energy to exercise.
Absolutely.
So something light before you exercise. Yogurt, if you like yogurt, piece of fruit. And maybe, you know, say banana and a little bit of peanut butter. So you want to keep it light.
Yes.
Or a piece of toast and peanut butter.
Yes, but keep it healthy.
Like keep it healthy,
then,
keep it light. And then after exercise, some protein, some carbs. Carbs you want because carb is the first energy source.
Okay.
And a little bit of fat too.
Okay.
So carbs, proteins, and fats, our bodies need those.
Yes.
So just a very light meal
with
a combination of those.
Okay.
And in terms of hydration, it is very important. Our bodies are made up of 60 to 70% water. And that's why we need to continually hydrate the body so it can, you know, function at its optimal level. Not only, you know, it's the brain too.
Yes,
you know,
exactly.
That's why they say kids should eat and drink before they go to school because they're sharper.
Yes.
It's the same for all of us.
Yes.
And so, you know, really it's a beverage that you'll enjoy. You know, water is the greatest source, but not everybody likes water. And so that's where those flavored energy drinks come in.
Yeah.
So really, whatever you're gonna drink, and try to stay away from soda as much as you can because it's, we call them empty calories.
Yes.
You know, but they're calories that will add weight to your body.
Yes.
And they
don't give you any
have any
energy or nutrition.
Any nutrition. And unfortunately, soda will give you energy and then you'll crash.
Yes.
You know, because there's a lot of sugar in it.
Yes. Okay.
So, that's what I would say for energy needs for exercising. I wanted to get back to the fourth component is flexibility.
Okay.
And now, you know, as we age, we start, you know, getting a little tighter.
Mm.
Okay. So stretching, flexibility is about your joints' range of motion. How healthy is it?
Oh.
So our shoulder is our only 360 degree range of motion joint. Okay. If we get tight, maybe this is as far as we're going to be able to go.
Ooh.
Okay. Yeah. So
you see
all the way around. Good, good, good. So that stretching will help keep the joint nice and healthy and prevent injury. Because if it gets tight and we do something, injury.
Yes.
And so we want to try to avoid injury. So stretching is very important.
Very important.
Very important. And then, so the fifth is body composition. Our ratio of lean muscle to fat in the body. And so muscle or lean tissue is muscle, bones, and organs. And then, you know, fat is essential and non-essential fat. So if we're doing all those first four and eating healthfully, it leads to a healthy body composition.
Oh, wow, that is fantastic. And now let us get to the demo part because, you know, we want to really show you, our viewers, those simple little things, you know, that we can do.
All right, so
to get going.
So I'm going to show you the first thing. I'm going to show a squat, and I'm going to show you at least two different ways that you can do them. First of all, what I love about squats is they mimic what we do every day.
Okay.
Getting in and out of the chair.
Yes.
Getting in and out of the car. Getting in and out of the chair at our dinner table.
Okay.
And when we go to the bathroom. So we want these strong thighs. So when we go shopping and we have to go to the bathroom, right?
Exactly.
All right. So with a squat, we want to think about form when we do our exercises.
Okay.
So I always talk about, think about a pillar holding up a roof. If a pillar is off to the side, you think that roof's going to come crashing down soon? All right, so we want to align up our joints. So in a squat, it's the knee and the ankle first.
Okay.
Okay? And so,
align that first.
So align that first, feet are hip-width apart, knees above the ankles. Okay. And so the only thing that we want to do, getting out of the chair, is we want to lift up and push into the heels and stand up.
So lift up from the back.
And then lift the body up, push into the heels, straighten the legs. Okay, so then when we sit down, hamstrings are working, hips are working, and then back down in the chair and seated nice and tall, ears over the shoulders, shoulders over the hips. And then again, come up, nice and slow, push into the heels, quadriceps working, hips working. So thighs and hips, inner and outer thighs help too.
Yeah, sometimes you do this mindlessly.
We do it all the time.
We just do it,
Okay, so that's number one. Okay. And so number two is take away the chair.
Okay.
All right, and there are many ways to vary this, but I'm gonna show a basic squat. So a basic squat, we're gonna add the arms, okay? So here, let's face one another, how about that? All right, feet are a little more than hip-width apart, so we're gonna bring the feet hip-width apart.
Okay, apart.
Toes straight ahead.
All
right, so we're gonna inhale down, bring the arms up, sit back, exhale, come back up. So imagine that chair behind you.
Yes.
You want to put the tailbone in the chair, not really, and then stand back up.
Oh, wow.
All right, and so sitting down, getting up, have more to do, got to go, got to go. All right, and that's it. So you want to do anywhere from 8 to 15.
Oh, wow.
8 to 15. You can vary how slow you go. The slower you go, the harder it is.
Yes.
Okay, and so, you know, you can do fast. If you want a little more cardiovascular, you can go really slow. How slow can she go? And then up, going shopping, got to go potty. got to go right now. But I do not want to sit on that potty. Right?
No.
All right, and come up nice and slow, nice and slow. Notice the difference when you go slow?
Yes.
You use more muscle fiber.
Muscle. Exactly, you feel it more.
Feel a little more here too, a little more in the heart, because our heart does have to pump blood to our muscles so that it gives them the oxygen to do the work we just asked them to do. So that's exercise number one that I always recommend for people. Exercise number two is a push-up. You can do a push-up up against the wall.
Okay, so let's imagine the wall is
imagine
there.
The wall. Hey, this is what we're
doing.
All right, the wall's in between us. And then we're gonna bend the elbows, come forward, and then push back. All right, and then forward. And so that's just a very, very light sample. So I'm gonna show you a way that you can use a chair. And is it okay if I turn the chair a little bit? So we start at the wall, then we come down to the chair. We want to bring our feet behind our hips. And so we want to keep our body in one long line, ear, shoulder, hip. So we want to push the hips forward. We want to keep them back. So we want to engage the abs. And then we're just going to come forward, elbows out, and then push the arm, push the body away. We're going to come forward on the toes, push back to the ball of the feet. All right, you can wall, chair, kitchen counter, the spaghetti's cooking. While that water's boiling and the spaghetti's cooking, some push-ups at the counter. Again, 8 to 20, 8 to 20. And then you can go down to your kitchen sink and then eventually get down on the floor.
Oh, wow. And so these are things that you can do. You can do. You know, that
at home, at work,
you know, take a break.
You go on vacation.
Rest against the wall, go on vacation, and just weave them in to 10, 15, and, you know, there you are. It doesn't seem so bad after all.
No, it's good. And the thing is, you do that 2 to 3 days a week. You want to give yourself 48-hour rest period. So, yes. For example, Monday and Wednesday, or Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Tuesday, Thursday. So every other day is really, yes. Because you want to give your muscles some time to rest
to
and
rest.
Recover.
Yes.
And so, you know, so you would, those two exercises I teach because they use your own body's resistance, which is really important to incorporate some of that. And they mimic what we do during the day.
Yes.
So for example, if you're going somewhere and you have to push a door open, that's like a push-up.
That yeah. is great. The great, great. I told you. Mm-hmm. I told you she makes it so simple, so fun, something you can weave into your everyday life. You know, not, you know, F word, go to the gym or necessarily,
yeah.
you know, and she can bring it to you. And those are the few tips for you. Now, the other thing in terms of the cardio, what is it that you recommend to really kind of help? Because that's an area the way I find a lot of people, mm-hmm. especially if you're a bit overweight, mm-hmm. even if you're underweight, mm-hmm. you know, whatever mm-hmm. appropriate weight, I find that a lot of us really just seem to keep running out of breath and mm-hmm. don't have the stamina to keep going, you know, and then you want to play with the kids or the grandkids and, oh, I'm tired. And they're like, come on, mom, you know, because mm-hmm. they've got all the energy.
Right.
You know, so what are some of the basic exercise we can do?
Again, like we were saying before, walking is great. We can walk. Walk
okay.
here, walk there, walk everywhere. Then you can add some hills. Or
yes.
you can go hiking, like you were saying,
yes.
in the woods.
What about dancing?
Dancing, again, is great. Really, you have to find something you love, something you enjoy that gives you passion. And the thing is, doing that consistently, and the recommendation is 5 days a week.
Yes.
30 minutes of moderate
okay,
activity. I like to do it most every day of the week. I like to do something because it gives me the energy that I
yes.
need. If you exercise on a regular basis, you will get more energy.
I know
Definitely.
That. I know that. I
yeah.
know that. And so those are the keys. We don't have time for more. I wish we did. And you can visit Lisa. You have your website.
I do.
And she's at Fitness in Motion LLC. If you search for it.
.com.
And you know my website is royalproclamations.com. And that the video is there. And you can contact Lisa through me. That's all we have time for today. I'm really excited. I hope at least you got something. I got something today that I could use.
Can I say one more thing?
You know, I got what I could use to really get me going, get me moving. And I hope you will too, because it's time to really spring alive and not just live for the moment, but think about the future, mm-hmm. about how we or where we want to be in a few short years from now. How fit do you want to be? And I'm sure you want to be around for longer. You wanted to say something quickly?
Yes, I just wanted to leave them with some very simple verbs that I like to share with my clients.
Okay.
First, like we were talking earlier, decide to exercise today if you haven't already. Plan what you're going to do and when you're going to do it. And then commit to it. Commit to it. A no-quit attitude. Sometimes that means enlisting some friends and family for accountability.
Yes.
And then persevere, because we have challenges in life.
Yes.
So just persevere, keep on keeping on. And then finally, you keep doing all that, you will achieve the healthiest body you possibly can.
Exactly. And you got it. Very simple. That's my whole philosophy.
Mm-hmm.
She's an inspirational woman, as you can see, and a motivator. And you do it, decide, commit today. It's your life. We want you around for a long time. And I look forward to really seeing you again next month. It's that time of the year. I have some very exciting broadcasts for you. I thank you so much for tuning in to Inspire Success. This is Princess Bola Adeleani reminding you to keep smiling. Hey, you know, life's too short. Keep learning, keep networking. Keep on keeping on. You're on the winning side. I'll see you next time. And thank you so much, Lisa. Thank
Welcome,
you for coming on Inspired Success. See you next time. Take care. God bless. Bye.